drinks here! These drinks here that are on the stage! Yes! Get them! Get them! I'm not gonna lie, you've made a poor decision! Well done! God bless you, and how fucking lucky you are! Don't you understand how fortunate you are to be sitting down there next to me? Don't you understand? I'm as confused as you! As to how that happened! The idea that I could be in two places simultaneously performing and watching myself! Fuck, I'm lucky! Fuck, I don't like me at all! Can I say? Also, whatever this is, this section of the room I'm just going to assume slightly poorer, because over here we've left our shit Chardonnay down here, but here, some Volvic, a touch of fruit. There you are. Take that from me at once. Can I say, with genuine love, I love all of you people, I love the fact that all of the testosterone has been deposited in these three men here. I like the fact that a whole room of people went, oh, that's a cum joke. There we are, we're with you. Just literally, look at you. Look at you with my fucking God. I shake you by the hand just to feel the masculinity run through you. He's amazing. His arms are so veiny, he doesn't have arms. They're just two extra cocks. This is... At which point I said that the woman next to him touched him on the arm. There we are. Behold, and then started rubbing her face on it. Fuck, I love the English. I love you people. I love the fact that you'll just do this. We'll play. We'll play along. Whatever you want, that's fine with me. I don't even know him. Ah, the friction's good. Don't do that. His fucking head will explode. Can I say? Should have been fingers down. That's the point. Yeah. Thank you. I've waited my whole life for someone to explain to me and me how sex works. And I'm so glad. I'm so glad it was a 2-3 cocked man. Just one guy walking around going, I want you to understand. When I curl this into a fist, bang! When I curl that into a fist, bang! I'm such a man, my dick has a fist on its own! When I get an erection, I punch myself in the mouth! And I feel good about it! I love you! It explains why your head's a fucking gonad! Can I say? Now! Now she hugs! Well done! I now understand everything I'll ever need to understand about your relationship! Just that moment ago, we're having fun! He's sensitive on the inside! I bet he is! He's got a soul like the TARDIS, it's big in there, out here, shallow as fuck. I love you. I love everything about you. I love the fact that as I pointed you, the man next to you has adopted the body language of a man who doesn't want to be seen. That's fine. Just a guy just going, well, if that's happened to him, anything could happen to me. You worry. I come to you because you are powerful and wonderful. I come to you because you are fucking huge. I come to you because that isn't a tiny moose on your fucking shirt. It's a regular sized moose. You're just fucking big. You're amazing. You make me so happy. You I like because I like a woman to be dressed for jail. Can I say? I don't know what I meant by that, but the important thing is God bless you. I've never seen anybody dress as the entire cast of the French cartoon Madeline before. Welcome. Good, no! That wasn't him knocking over a drink, that's the sound he makes when he becomes tumescent, ladies and gentlemen. Just the sound of glass breaking as Stone Cold Steve Austin leaps out of his car. Hey, you wrestling fans! How are you? How am I? Aren't we great? Hey, son. Now! Actually, if I could hold on. I touched myself! And everybody had to watch. It's everything I've ever wanted. That's why you get into comedy. Fuck, I like this version of me better than I like myself. You're wonderful. Go to our car. Can I say? I don't have a car. Fuck it. We'll share an Oyster car. Yeah. With my wife. She'll be delighted. My wife will be so happy. You mean you brought home another you, but it's a girl for... I'll have to leave. I say this. Actually, fuck it. We'll all have to leave. This man will just walk through the door. One eyebrow cocked and every woman in the row pregnant. Can I say? Never let that... Now he covers his mouth just to stop it happening to us. Now, I understand, my darling, because I've just seen what's happened there as you think to yourself, well, this is certainly happening. And he's shouting. I wish he wouldn't do that. Now, don't worry.
We can always do that. And I like doing this just for a moment. One, because it's a lot easier. But the other because...
When I do this, fuck, I'm frightening!
But when I do this...
Still quite fucking scary, let's be clear. I say this, you people, hey, I say this, you people will not understand the heartbreak I have when I get up in the morning. You've been up since you were fucking born. No one, no one understands. I get up in the morning and I'm happy to see you because you look like what I think I would look like maybe if I had that taste in outfits, and I love you. I love them. I wish I could pull off a skirt like that. Oh, fuck off. A room of people who just went, oh, pull off, as in take off. No, I wish I was a beautiful woman. That's all I want. Don't you understand what this is about? Don't you understand what a fucking disappointment this is to me? Don't you people understand how unfair evolution is? Because look at me! This is as good as it gets! And what a shit-ass Pokemon I turned out to be! Tell you this, because I get up in the morning, and I walk down the street, and people yell shit at me. This happens continually. There are different demographics for it. A hobo, a homeless man, has taken to heckling me on the street. He no longer asks for change. He has found something more valuable than my money, and it is my pain. I walk down the street. When I walk down the street, my hair blows back like that, and I will hear this man from somewhere down here go, fuck, it's Peter Stringfella. You don't understand. I'm a recent migrant to this country. Don't heckle me with said great celebrities I don't fucking know. And then I had to look up. It's all right, though, because kids look at me and go, fuck, Draco Malfoy's dead. It's fine, sir, fuck it, don't tell me. I say this to all of you. I do. I love all of you people. I love each and every one of you people. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter if you're this man whose shirt wasn't white until he sat in front of that man. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. This young man, you're my favourite. The rest of you sicken me. Leave. You I like. I've never seen a man, to be fair to you, sit in a cooler manner. A man whose entire body language just suggests, hey, you can come here or not. It doesn't matter. I've never enjoyed myself sitting down as much as I am right now. This is incredible. See, over here, God bless you, you're playing this on London Tube rules. Here's a guy just going, make myself as small as I possibly can. Link my fucking own. It's gone. You look like you've been sprayed with bug repellent. You look like you're gently dying. Whereas this man, I liked it. This man. See what I mean? Not just appearance, but also quite cruel as well. Pardon me?
Thing. They get it.
Only I could explain my joke to me. I had no idea that my inner monologue had taken human form. That's genuinely what I was thinking. Just that moment again, what, I spray that do nothing for you? And then out of nowhere, my conscience, my Jiminy Cricket, if you will, my adorable Jiminy Cricket, I would tell a lie just to be inside you. I say this. It's me, fuck off. I'm talking to myself, you pricks. How dare you try to censor my inner self? I just like that as I'm going, no, no, bike spray, no, no, no. Out of nowhere! Fuck, we're having fun! Shut up, my friend! I say this! Did you just say you don't know what's going on? You'll never understand us! I'm having a family reunion just with my... Fuck all you people! The man who sits in a cool way, this will never happen to you! I say this! No, no, no! I've literally never enjoyed my act so much! We have just the fact that out of nowhere, look, I've been doing comedy 13 years. I presume, how old are you?
I'm old, 39.
Are you 39?
I'm old, yeah.
I had no idea. Am I?
How old are you? Yeah.
Oh. I see you've taken such an interest in our friendship. And you don't know how old I am. Well, I'll tell you this. I'm 30. No, I'm not. How long have we known them? 30 years.
Yeah, this one a lot longer.
I like her the best. I can see why we've held on to that friendship. These are like work friends, aren't they? Kind of casual acquaintances that we've just taken out. I just want to say this, and I say this with genuine love. I'm 30. You're 39. From where I am, the future looks good. It's very nice. I hope that when I am eventually where you are, I look exactly like you. And I hope that when I'm doing that, you're doing my job. So I can sit down there and watch you. And you two, you could both fuck off. You're probably delightful. I don't know you. We don't care. The thing is, folks, I fucking love all of you people. I love the fact that it's a room of people and one chair just for my ego. I fucking do. And it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if you're two young men who both thought to themselves, flannel tonight, no one else will do that. Just two young men made to sit together, God bless you, you look like a fucking tablecloth. Yeah, two. Oh, well done. I'm so nice to my friend that, oh, okay. Now, as it turns out, I'm now touching me. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, who knew? Who knew that tonight was just going to turn into a radical self-love symposium? What the fuck is going on? I just turned to my friend, whose name I probably know, and just did this. Hey, turn and look at them. I am such a good friend to my friends that I will explain how visual comedy works. Fuck, ow. I say this. Rapidly aging. I tell you this. I fucking do. I love all of you. I love each and every one of you people. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if I made a joke that only I fucking understood about you. It doesn't matter. I love you too. Fuck, this is nice. I'm not gonna lie. This is as many people as I talk to ever. Because I live in fucking London. You know? We don't talk to people if we can avoid it. You get on the tube. Somebody gets on the tube. He's naked. He's fucking a cup of butter. Part of you goes, who gets butter in a cup? Well done. There's that moment of going, should I stop him? And then going, no, I'd have to talk to someone, no. No, this can't happen at all. But this is wonderful. See, comedians, they get into this business because what you've got to understand is what you've paid money to see is a succession of increasingly mentally ill people. That's what's occurred here. This is our therapy. And after 13 years of stand-up comedy, one, I've got a room of friends who, I'm not going to lie, this is how friendship with me works. I say I'm your fucking friend. Take it. To the point that I've reached, I'm not going to lie, I found myself. Some people go to Nepal for this shit. Some people go up Everest. I worked 20 minutes down the road and I found me. That's fucking amazing. I found female me in the future. My intermediate future apparently gets quite strange. Somewhere between now and then, I finally decide, get it done. And I say this, because I like the idea that what I'm currently having is a therapy session for myself in the future. Just that moment of being like, hey, you, future me. It's me, younger you. Remember? I'm just trying to be like you. I don't know what I mean by that, but the important thing is the dirty boys at the back like it. Have you ever heard such a back at the fucking bus laugh? Just a group of people, you know what they were like when they were 12, don't you? Just sitting there and be going, Bumster! Ah, Willie's, ah! I drew a fucking swastika kissing on itself, ah! How does one do that? Probably the same place. Where do you get a fucking self-jizzing swastika? Probably the same shop where you buy a cup of butter. I say this.
Beavis and Butthead back here, mate.
What's that, love? Yes. Well done. Is there anything in the world as good as a heckle that isn't? Just that moment of one young man going, excuse me, I... What you said! Thank you. This is one thing I fucking love about this country. You people have been trained since Panto to respond. You fucking have. He's behind you. I know he isn't. Oh, yes, he is. That's how we're going to catch that sex offender, ladies and gentlemen. I wish I'd stopped doing that with my hand. Wow, fuck. Yeah, I'm not going to lie. I just folded my arms at me. Just that moment ago. Yeah, I remember when I was 30. Always making that joke, always doing that with my fucking hand. Things are different now. I got a friend that I value. Some other people. Oh, look at that. Well.
You get a lot out of that.
Was that my... Oh, did you just say, you're not going to get a lot out of that? Thanks, mate. Is there anything in the world as enjoyable as a man who sits there waiting for his moment? And goes, well, it's been a long day for me today. You know what I'm really looking forward to later? I think I'm going to point out a really obvious thing.
You're so big as a butthead.
Sometimes when I get up in the morning and it's sunny, I say, nice morning. I had a great time. Sometimes when it's raining and someone comes in and they're a bit wet, I say, is it raining? I tell you, it's a simple life, but it's... You know, like if I were to commit to that, I'd be like, hey, mate, that woman there, she's not you. That's someone else. Don't you know? God bless you. God bless a man who, upon seeing an empty wine bottle and an empty bottle, you won't get much out of that. One, you're wrong, because I just got a minute of good material. And two, I look forward to your gravestone, which will simply read, I'm dead.
And here's David Copperfield, so we'll measure something up.
Folks, you have been a beautiful group of people. My name is John Robertson. That's still my name when I'm down there.
Joanne.
Pardon me?
Huh?
The gig finished, shut up. Now, heckling when the show's over is just abuse. Now, righto, John Robertson, I'm at thejohnrobertson.com. I've got a very big show at South Bank Centre on May 28th called John Robertson's The Dark Room, which is it's kind of exactly like this, except it isn't, because none of my shows are, because it's really hard to have to pay to have... Well, two fucking tickets, yeah. Oh, did you say I'm going to be there? Well, yeah, of course you're going to be. I've got to do the fucking show. Gee, I'm glad I'm still funny when I'm 39. Yeah. You've been a beautiful group of people. Have yourselves a beautiful rest of your weekend. My name is John Robertson.